Good day to everyone. So in the last class, we have seen about the introduction about the elasticity and the different notions, the stress strain and the relation between the stress strain defined by the Hooke's law and the different rigidity model, the different modulus, rigidity modulus, Young's modulus and the bulk modulus and the mathematical derivation we have seen in the last class with the Poisson ratio. So in this class, we are going to see about the what is the relation between the angle of shear and the linear strain. So we have seen this problem is in the earlier class itself. So the relation between angle of shear that is actually defined as a phi and the linear strain. That is actually mentioned as delta L. So we have seen this problem as that it take a rectangle, sorry, square. Suppose if you take a square, the sides are mentioned as A, B, C, and D. And suppose if I apply a force, tangential force into this, so we can see that the DC, CD, the face of CD is actually fixed with the floor. So if you apply a force, then this body will be give the reshape to this angle, so that the angle of shear can be written as phi. Okay, so the deviation is can be taken as say A prime and B prime. So the distance between the A prime can be taken as delta L, and the B prime is also equal to the delta L. Okay, so the new parallelogram is actually the originally it actually became in a square with the shape of A B C D, and now after the applying a force, this actually become a parallelogram with the shear sides of A prime, B prime, C and D, and so with the through the angle through which the face AD and BC has been turned into is evidently the shear of strain, which is actually mentioned as a phi. So the diagonal D, suppose if I plot a diagonal between the D and B, DB is actually DB, but after the elongation it is actually become a D and sorry this is taken, maybe taken as a phi, and so now it is the angle is actually taken as a DB prime. So what happened is this DB is actually elongated to DB prime. At the same time, this AC is actually in a shortened with the A prime C. Suppose if I draw a perpendicular line between the DB and DB prime, which is meeting the point of DB prime at the point of K, and suppose since the phi is very small, then the angle, so that means that the triangle BKB prime is a this may be assumed as a right angle, isosceles triangle. So I can assume this would be the BKB prime is isosceles triangle, so that the angle between the B prime K can be taken as a 45 degree, since this is actually a 90 degree, so this may be taken as a 45 degree. So what I am going to do is, so for the DB, which is approximately equal to the DK, since it's a right angle triangle, so this length DB and this DK will be almost equal. So this I am assuming that, so that I can write the tensile strain along the diagonal DB. Along DB can be written as, so I can write as E, that is equal to the variation in the final angle, the final length dB prime minus the original angle, original length divided by the original length dB prime, dB. So the dB prime is the variation length. So the variation in length can be taken as a dP prime minus dB divided by the original length, which I can write it as dB prime minus. So this dB is, I can change it as a dK because this dB and dK is approximately equal. So I can try take this dB as a dK divided by the whole dB, so that I can write it as the dP prime minus dK is actually equal to the kB prime. That is the difference between the dB and dB prime is nothing but the kB prime divided by the dB. However, suppose if you look into the triangle of BKB prime, in which the KB prime divided by the BB prime is nothing but the, suppose where you can see this is the BKB prime, you can just take the cos theta, the cos of angle, the 45 degree, which give you the KB prime divided by BB prime, so that I can write it as a, so which can be written as, means KB prime, I can write it as a KB prime, which is equal to BB prime into cos of 45, and you know the value of cos 45 is nothing but the 1 by root 2, so I can write it as BB prime divided by whole root 2, or the BB prime is already know that the value of BB prime is, I already know that is a delta L. So I can write it, this iteration KB prime is nothing but the delta L divided by square root of 2, that is nothing but the KB prime. Okay. So we already know this dB prime is nothing from the Pythagoras theorem. We can write the find out the value of dB using the value of dC squared, the square root of dC squared plus BC squared. That will give you that this is nothing but the value of L, length is L, total length is L. So I can write this dB, which is equal to the square root of dC squared plus BC squared. That is nothing but the square root of 2L squared, because this is 1L squared and another 1L squared, that is 2L squared. Or I can write dB, which is equal to L times of square root of 2. So I know the what is the value of dB now. So I can write just substitute the values of this KB prime and dB, KB prime and dB in this equation of E, so that the E is actually E is known as E is equal to KB prime divided by dB. I know the values of the KB prime relation is nothing but the delta L the root 2, so the delta L divided by square root of 2, the whole divided by, I mean the divided by dB, dB is nothing but the L into root 2, so I can write it as into 1 divided by L into square root of 2, so I can write this as, so this root 2 and this root 2 will become 2, so that I can write it as, delta L divided by 2L, or I can write this delta L as BB prime divided by 2L, or so delta L divided by L, H is already know that it is a shear, that means the phi, so delta L divided by L is nothing but the shear, so that I can write E is equal to L divided by, sorry, delta L divided by 2L, or the, you can write this E is equal to phi divided by 2. So that is the, either you can write it as delta L divided by 2L, or I can write this delta L divided by L is as known as the angle of shear, so that I can write the stress, the tensile strength which is equal to delta L by 2 L or the phi by 2. So this is the relation between the angle of shear and the linear strain. Similarly, suppose this is actually having tensile strain. Suppose if we want to calculate the compressive strain, suppose if I want to compress this strain, I have to calculate because we want to compress this strain, which is actually that means in the angle means in the side of A prime, that means AC and AC prime, because so this in this area it is actually compressed, so that instead of calculating the elongated strain, I can also calculate the compressive strain in the angle AC and A prime C. So this will give you the relation as again is the same the AC, which is equal to phi by 2 again, because the shearing strain phi is equivalent to the tensile strain, and the compressive strain is at the right angles to each other, so that each are having the same value of phi by 2. So similarly, it can also be proved that the shearing strain is equivalent to the linear tensile strain and equal to the compressive stress at right angles to each other. Okay. So next we see about the problem. Problem one. So I can say that one end of the steel rod of radius r is equal to 9.5 mm. And the length of L is equal to 81 centimeter is held in a vise. The force of F with the magnitude of F is equal to 62 kilo Newton is then applied perpendicularly to the end face at the end face. That means uniformly across the whole area at the other end, pulling directly away from the vise. So what are the stress on the rod and the elongation delta L and the strain of the rod? So we have to find out what is the stress as well as the stress happened due to the elongation L and the corresponding strain in the rod, which is occurred in this rod. So one thing I have already given is the Young's modulus of the iron rod is constant, is given as a 2 into 10 power 11 newtons per meter square. So we have to find out the solution for this. So before going into the solution, so we have some key ideas. That means because of the force is perpendicular to the end face and the uniform to the whole rod, the stress is stress is the ratio of the magnitude of F and the force acting on the unit area. So thus so the F by A, which is equal to E into delta L divided by L. So that is actually the Young's modulus. F by A is equal to E into delta L by L. The another point, the first point is this one, and second point is the elongation L, the delta L is related to the stress of the Young's modulus, because we are talking about the longitudinal and the longitudinal stress and strain. So we have elongation L is related, delta L is related to the stress and the Young's modulus E. Okay, so the third point is the strain is the ratio of the elongation in the initial length L. That means the strain which we can define as delta L divided by L. So these are all the points which we have to keep in mind, so that we have to find out, first we have to find out the stress. Okay, so to find the stress, okay, so you already know the stress formula, stress which is equal to F divided by A. So A is again, talking about the A is a radius. So you can just find out the F is equal to F divided by R squared. R is already we know. The area is pi R squared, which we can easily find out. The F is already given here. That is nothing but the 62 kilo Newton. So I can write this as 6.2 into 10 power 4 joules. 10 power 4 Newton divided by pi. By the value of pi is already known, 3.1415 into the R squared. The radius is actually given as 9.5 mm. So I can write it as 9.5 into 10 power minus 3 meter the whole square. Okay, so you can do the simple calculation just doing the calculation. The final answer is actually given as 2.2 into 10 power 8 Newton per meter squared. That is the stress applied to the rod with the force of 6.2 into 10 power 4 Newton. So the field strength of the structural steel is, suppose if you consider the yield strength, that means yield strength means the breaking point of the stress, the breaking point of the iron steel is actually 2.5 into 10 power 8 Newton per meter squared. So the force which is applied to this rod is actually equivalent to this yield strength, so that the rod is actually dangerously close to the yield strength. As we already know, the Young's modulus of the iron rod is actually given as 2 into 10 power 11 Newton per meter squared. We can easily find out the elongation. To find the elongation, so the elongation is nothing but the delta L, which can be written as, so F divided by A into L divided by E. You already know this Young's modulus, that means the Young's modulus E is equal to F L divided by A into delta L, which we already know that. You just rewritten as a delta L is equal to F by A into L divided by E, so that I can easily just substitute the values of all these things. So F divided by A, which already we have find out that is nothing but the 2.2. So I can write this as 2.2 into 10 power 8 Newton per meter squared into the L. Length is nothing but the length which is given is 81 millimeter. So I can write 81 centimeter. I can write it as in terms of meters. So I can write it as 0.81 meters divided by the value E, which is already given as 2 into 10 power 11. So 2 into 10 power 11 Newton per meter squared. So after doing the mathematical steps, you can just do it in the calculator, so that I can, the final answer is 8.9 into 10 power minus 4 meters. That is actually the delta L, or you can write this as delta L, which is equal to 0.89 of millimeters. So this is the elongation happened in the rod. Suppose if you apply a force of this magnitude, okay. So next we have to find out the strain. What is the strain? So for the strain, we already have the formula delta L divided by L, that means the change in length and divided by the total length. So we have already calculated the change in length is nothing but the 8.9 into 10 power minus 4 meters divided by the total length is already given as 0.81 of meters. That means 81 millimeter, I can just write it in terms of meters. So that the meter will get cancelled, I will get the 1.1 into 10 power minus 3. So it is actually unitless. The strain is always the unitless ratio. So I can write it as 0.11 percentage is the total strain occurred in the rod with this force. Suppose if you increase or decrease the force, then you can find out what happening into the iron rod. Suppose this is the 62 is actually changed to the 80 or something, then the rod will actually reach the yield strength, more than the yield strength, so that the due to this stress the iron rod will become will break, or the permanent elongation will happen in the iron rod. Okay. So this is a simple problem where you can find out the corresponding stress, strain, as well as the what is the change in length happened into the rod due to the applied force. So similarly, you can solve these problems using the formulas. So only thing is you have to remember the the formulas, the corresponding formulas, then how to you should know how to apply this into the problem. Okay, so probably I stop here with this example, and we can see the work done in a strain in the neither for the in the next class. Suppose if you have any doubt in this topic, then we can discuss it in the online class. Thank you.